Look,
what is the role of Wall Street?
Well,
what did I do?
Well, the Wall Street is a legitimate organization, which is has probably more rules and regulations than many other companies. But the criminals don't break the law like other criminals don't break the law. Of course, there are bad apples. I mean, there's not no doubt about it.
There are, but
however, if let's say you have a killer in the street. And you put that specific killer behind bars. It doesn't mean that you have put everybody behind bars. One single bad person shouldn't give bad name to the whole of humanity, right?
It's more than one person.
Okay, there are more than one killers, but it doesn't mean that all humanity is bad, right? So why would you say if there is one?
All these people are losing their homes.
Well, see, you just said all people. Only all these people. Yes, there are bad apples.
Losing homes.
Yes, there are. Bad people on Wall Street, I agree. But you say they're all bad. How can I say they're all bad? Are you saying that there are no good Wall Street people? There's not a single person?
It's symbolic of greed.
No, it's symbolic. Greed is a good thing. It's about capitalism. Are you against capitalism?
It's symbolic of greed.
But what about capitalism? It's not just greed, it's capitalism.
There's
greed
all kinds
is making.
Of capitalists.
What's that?
There's all kinds.
But are you for capitalism or against capitalism?
The good ones are for.
But where did you draw the
line?
Not
the ones that are closing up their factories here and shipping it overseas for cheap labor.
Well, if we reduce the taxes and reduce the regulations, these jobs would have stayed here. It's the Democrats who interest.
They're not making enough money. They got to close up the factories.
What's your definition?
Your questions are bullshit and your bullshit.
What's your definition of enough money then?
What's that?
What's your definition of enough money then? Where do you draw the line? When you say enough money, what's enough?
Enough money.
Yes.
You have your little house.
How big?
Enough, big enough for your family.
$100,000, $200,000, $1 million, $10 million.
Well, where do you draw the line? Respected. He gave his life for this country.
I respect. I know.
Changes all the time.
That's more than a lot of people did.
I'm sorry?
Look, when I got married, I paid $45 a month rent.
Some people respect the fact that we're trying to make music here.
Now I'm still paying cheap. I'm paying close to $1,000. It's cheap. But I really can't afford those prices.
Yeah, but the point is, it seems like you're against people making money. Isn't it
they
a good thing?
They can make money, but let other people live also. I'm not against this.
But the rich people give the jobs. But if not for the rich people...
They give a shit. They're going overseas. They go to China.
When Bush was the president, unemployment, the lowest point unemployment under Bush was 4.5%, which is normal. Most of the people were in between the jobs.
But when he left, how much was it?
Well, but it's not because of Bush. It's a natural cycle, first of all. Second of all, because we elected Barack Obama...
What was the rate of unemployment when he left?
It was less than 8%, 7.2, 7.8, something. No. It was less. Let's bet. Remember?
8.7.
No. When he left the office, it was under
8%. 8.7.
And Barack Obama, he promised to stimulate the economy.
He went into a war. With weapons of mass destruction, he killed over 100,000 Iraqis and over 4,000 troops.
Did Schumer vote for the war in Iraq?
What's that?
Schumer, did he vote for the war in Iraq? Did Hillary Clinton vote for the war in Iraq? Did John Kerry vote for the war in Iraq?
If they voted for them...
They all did. Most of the Democrats voted for the war in Iraq. Most of them, right?
But did they apologize? They said they made a mistake.
Ah, okay.
They made a mistake.
Okay, but how can you... It's like saying...
Bush never said he made a mistake.
He said 2020 is...
The Democrats at least said they made a mistake.
It wasn't a mistake.
They said they were fools.
Yeah, but...
They believed Bush.
But... Weren't we attacked on 9/11 right here? I mean, right behind you. You were in the war. What war did you participate in, by the way? Korean War? World War II?
The Civil War.
No, you said so World War II. What theater?
I was in the Civil War.
Where do you fight?
What theater?
Where do you fight?
In Europe. I was in the States. I was aboard ship.
But where specifically? What parts of the world? I mean, it was a global war.
I was on two trains.
Okay.
So that man was right. I'm from Holland, so we owe you respect.
Of course. Yes. Yes.
I was all over the world.
Yeah, but see, a lot of people we were attacked, but following this gentleman's war hero logic, we were attacked on 9/11. See, when we were attacked in Pearl Harbor, we went to war and we defeated the enemy, right?
Yeah.
Now, we were attacked right here. I mean, it happened right here.
So what did Iraq have to do with it?
Of course it has everything to do with the war.
Why?
Because Iraq did have weapons of mass destruction.
Iraq didn't have it when
Iraq did use weapons of mass destruction.
According to the International Atomic Energy Commission, they didn't have it. When did I go in?
Well, this is the greatest generation. No doubt about it. I mean, it's a great respect for what you did during the Second World War.
This is the only legitimate foreign war that this country ever waged.
What about Cold War?
Which one?
Cold War. The Soviets,
that's
the Russians.
I'm talking about hot wars.
Well, but it was also war. Yeah, but it could have become hot.
They were our ally during the Second World War. What do you got to say about that?
Well, but the Soviets started the Second World War. You know that. The Russians are just as culpable.
Where are you from? What country?
I am from Russia.
Yeah?
Yeah, I am from Russia.
What part of Russia?
Moscow.
Yeah. They started it.
What's that?
The Russians started the Second World War.
Of course. They didn't. September 1st, 1939. Remember what happened on September 1st? And what did the Russians do?
I don't know what the fuck they did.
You don't know what the Russians did?
But I know that Germany ran into Russia too.
So you don't know that Poland was divided and it ceased to exist as an independent country. You know that, right?
It started in Spain in 1937, 36.
Well, yeah, but I'm talking about the Second World War.
Well,
it started with the Russians and the Germans dividing up Poland, right?
It started in Spain in 1936.
You know,
I just hope I have this man's age to have as strong mission as he has now.
What's that?
That's right. I hope when I have your age, I hope to have as strong a mission as you have. That's great.
It's movements like this that give me the will to live.
Okay.
When I see people fighting back.
Against what? Capitalism? What
are we doing? They're fighting back because they came here to rouse the people. It's happening all over the world.
Yeah, but what's the goal of Occupy Wall Street? Can you define?
They're not calling to the end of capitalism. They're calling for jobs, right?
But how do you create jobs? I saw the sign, fight for socialism, abolish capitalism. That's the sign that I might cross it. Came across it. So you believe?
There's all kinds of people. That's what makes it beautiful.
Okay, yeah, that's good, but
all kinds of people.
But do these people have like overwhelming goal, like the general
problem,
goal?
The problem is that most of the people here are really, fighting for better conditions. They're fighting for jobs.
But just by sitting over here, actually quitting jobs
it's
to come over here.
All over the world. They started all over the country.
But they want socialism. That's the problem with socialism.
They
don't. They don't want socialism. You never saw the signs fight.
I'm sure you see signs. You see all kinds of signs.
Okay, then how do you think that...
Don't accentuate the negative.
But how do you think that they can achieve their goals?
You got to accentuate the positive. That's the negative. You know what that means?
So how do you think that they
can... What does accentuate the positive?
But how do you think that they can achieve their goals?
What does accentuate the positive?
I'm sorry?
Accentuate the positive.
I still don't understand. I'm sorry.
I know you don't understand it.
Alright, see ya.
He doesn't understand accentuate the positive. That's what you gotta do. Accentuate the positive.
Oh, accentuate the positive. Oh, accentuate the positive.
Eliminate the negative.
Well, yeah, but I'm just talking about the goals. How can they achieve their goals of reducing unemployment, like you're saying? I mean, what are their proposals? Specific concrete proposals, do you know?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Who's them?
Well, they occupy Wall Street.
There's all kinds of people here. Who's them?
So they
majority want jobs.
How? How to get them?
How?
Yes, how?
Let the people in Wall Street, they're making billions of dollars.
Yes.
Invest in building factories.
But they do invest.
No,
do invest.
Don't.
So what do you think they do with their money?
What do? They buy a little island someplace.
Do they buy boats? Do they buy boats? Yachts? Do they buy planes? Right?
They buy anything they want.
Okay, but who builds them? Who builds the yachts? Who builds the planes? What if they stop buying anything?
Who built all this?
Well, exactly. That's how they create. That's how they create jobs.
Okay, so there's no problems in our country.
Well, there are problems.
No problems.
The problems are with too much socialism in this country. That's where the problem is.
They need a little fascism. It's better.
We need a little fascism. So you think a little fascism is a good thing?
I think that's what you think.
Well, I came from Russia. I escaped from Russia. No, how can I think the fascism is good?
You got Russian fascists too.
Yeah.
And you sound like one.
I sound like a fascist.
Yes, yes.
So that's what you think.
Because, you know, when they put Hitler in power, all the big corporations, Krupp, Tyson, all of them, you know.
But what's wrong with big corporations?
Power. To protect their riches.
Well, the fascism, the definition of fascism, when the production, the big corporations are controlled by the government. Barack Obama, when he purchased General Motors, that is fascism.
Fascism is to red bait everybody, no matter what they say.
I'm sorry, to do what?
They red bait everybody's a communist because they're standing up for something. That's what fascism is. They try to put everybody down. If you say something, well, you're a communist. By the way, they red bait.
Okay, so you think fashion is a good thing?
You're protecting the very wealthy, the rich. They're very good people. What are you doing? What are you trying to do?
Nothing. I'm just observing.
What are you trying to prove?
I am just observing people like you. I come from Russia, and it pains me, really pains me, when I see misguided people who never lived under communism.
But the thing is this, according to the polls, I don't think communist dictatorship. According to the polls, the majority of the American people agree with them.
Agree with their aim. Occupy Wall Street, with their aim. And their aim is to steal from the rich, to take from the rich.
Did you read the papers?
So
I'm talking about the polls.
So you really think that the majority of Americans agree with their ideology, which can't even be defined?
What is it, son? What do you define? You're defining it.
Well, I ask you, what's their ideology?
One person.
Okay.
My thinking is that they're fighting for a better life. The jobs and security. That's what I'm thinking. That's it.
All right. Okay, well, thank you for your...
You can put having nuts that's carrying a sign. And the wooden brush, everybody would say, but that's all it's saying. There's all kinds of people. I think my thinking is the same with millions of other Americans about the insecure life that they live.
And you think that socialism can give them security?
People, I ain't talking about socialism.
But that's what they're advocating.
They're not.
They're not. All right. Okay, well, thank you so much for your service.
if that was the case, what you're talking about, there'd be hundreds of thousands of communists in this country.
Well, they are. But you don't believe that. That's okay. All right. Nice talking
to
you.
They want a decent life. A decent, secure life.
So you have made Wall Street the tomb of greed and corruption. Okay. Okay. That's your opinion. Thank you.
I said, just trying to tune everybody. Burn in hell, corporate thieves.
Corporate thieves. All right.
Burn in hell, corporate thieves.
All right. So no more rich.
The good ones, they can live.
So no more rich, right? In other words.
The dead ones should burn in hell.
So it does.
I didn't say no more rich. You're wrong. Don't put words in my mouth.
So you are for rich, just not too
rich.
I'm
not for rich. I'm not for poor. I'm for everybody to have a fair shake, a good life. What's wrong with that?
Nothing wrong.
That's
nothing wrong.
I'm a humanist.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you for your service.